you can share with us about the universe. The most astounding fact, the most astounding fact is the knowledge that the atoms that comprise life on Earth, the atoms that make up the human body, are traceable to the crucibles that cooked light elements into heavy elements in their core under extreme temperatures and pressures. These stars, the high mass ones among them, went unstable in their later years. They collapsed and then exploded, scattering their enriched guts across the galaxy. Guts made of carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, and all the fundamental ingredients of life itself. These ingredients become part of gas clouds that condense, collapse, form the next generation of solar systems, stars with orbiting planets. And those planets now have the ingredients for life itself. So when I look up at the night sky, and I know that, yes, we are part of this universe, we are in this universe, but perhaps more important than both of those facts is that the universe is in us. When I reflect on that fact, I look up. Many people feel small because they're small and the universe is big, but I feel big because my atoms came from those stars. There's a level of connectivity. That's really what you want in life. You want to feel connected. You want to feel relevant. You want to feel like you're a participant in the goings-on of activities and events around you. That's precisely what we are, just by being alive.
Yeah. Thank you. organizer and a communicator.
He thought about life among our planet and Earth, life on our Earth.
When Carl was 5 years old, his mom got him a library card because he wanted to learn more about the stars, he said.
The answer was stunning. It was that the sun was a star, but really close. The stars were suns, but so far away, they were just little points of light. The scale of the universe suddenly opened up to me. It was a kind of religious experience. There was a magnificence to it, a grandeur, a scale which has never left me, never, ever left me.
They called this the family portrait, the corner look of our galaxy.
Carl Sagan asked NASA to have the Voyagers do one more special task.
Traveling at 40,000 miles per hour, Voyager was the first man-made object to be launched out of our solar system.
Carl wanted Voyager to turn back its cameras and take a faraway point of Earth.
And so, in 1990, 12 years after it was first launched,
from 3.5 billion miles away,
Voyager turned and took a long exposure capture of our planet.
It took 3 months to send a picture back home to NASA.
When you saw it for the first time, it was awe-inspiring to see.
For so long, humans had looked up at the stars.
Now we can see what the stars might see looking back at us.
There, in a scattered beam of starlight from our sun, was a pale blue dot, Earth.
We are part of this universe. We are in this universe. But perhaps more important than both of those facts is that the universe is in us. When I reflect on that fact, I look up. Many people feel small because they're small and the universe is big, but I feel big because my atoms came from those stars. is a level of connectivity. That's really what you want in life. You want to feel connected. You want to feel relevant. You want to feel like you're a participant in the goings-on of activities and events around you. That's precisely what we are, just by being alive.